So last week, we were joined by progressive advocacy journalist Lauren Windsor, who registered for a Rick Santorum conservative event on Capitol Hill. It was supposed to be a private event, but she got in anyway, shared with us some video that she obtained from that gathering of Representative Mike Johnson from Louisiana, talking about the goal of overturning Roe v. Wade. Very quickly, you go back and watch that clip from last week.
Basically, that Amy Coney Barrett would, he in his mind, he's known her since high school, and he would imagine that we're close to overturning Roe
right.
in the context of knowing Amy Coney Barrett. He said he thinks
right.
Roe is on the table now.
And he said, I she's itching, basically, to write this. He thinks, you know, it could be 5-4, 6-3 that she might even author this opinion. He talked about the putting life into the agenda for House Republicans
right.
when they took over in 2023. Windsor has now shared with us a new video that she got from that gathering. This is Representative Ken Buck, who was one of the leading authorities on the Republican side on the antitrust fight. And he's talking here about Google's role in the 2020 election. Let's roll that.
Google, by the way, changed its algorithm in May of 2020 to disadvantage Donald Trump and to advantage Joe Biden. Changed its algorithm. And when you ask them about this, and I know people that own newspapers and ask them about it, they say, oh, well, that's just a technical thing. We don't know what the result was. We just know that a technical person did this. Nonsense. They chose the winner. They can move, the estimates are, they move 15 million votes. Because every time you ask for an article on Donald Trump, or every time you Google Donald Trump, and people here obviously Google in a more sophisticated way, but people out there, they're hearing about Donald Trump, and they're wondering, you know, Donald Trump, Hunter Biden.
So first of all, there's a fascinating Republican tick in there, which is, I know people who own newspapers. When people say there's no difference between the two parties, the Democrats don't say that.
Right.
You know, they say, I've talked to journalists, or you know, I've talked to editors, or at my dinner party with the newscaster.
Noted journalist Jeff Bezos tells me.
Right. I know people who own newspapers. It reminds me of Mitt Romney. When he was asked about NASCAR, he's like, well, several of my friends own NASCAR teams, so of course I'm into NASCAR. Anyway, have you heard this conspiracy theory before that Google changed its algorithm, and which they very well may have, but that it then resulted in 15 million votes swinging?
So that's the thing, right? So basically everything that Ken Buck said in there, with the exception of the 15 million estimate that I think he just sort of dropped in casually, is accurate and I think is pretty inoffensive. Like, Google absolutely changed the algorithm. That should shock absolutely nobody. But there are these estimates that float around based on studies. I think the guy's name is Richard Epstein, who is a professor, and he's an academic, and did a study trying to estimate how many votes could have been swayed by the changes in Google's algorithm in 2016 and in 2020, or by probably suppression of the Hunter Biden information in 2020. This is an almost impossible thing to quantify. And I think using the quantifications, especially at that massive number, I'm assuming, I don't know for sure. I know you reached out to Ken Buck's office, and maybe we'll know more about this as we continue our communications with them on this. And I believe they've been invited onto the show, or will be
Absolutely.
Invited onto the show to talk about this. I'm guessing that 15 million estimate was pulled in some way from the Epstein estimate that has sort of floated around before in 2016 and 2020. But it is a very, very difficult thing to quantify. And so I'm not sure that using numbers like that or relying on studies like that are particularly productive. But I do think it's fair to say that directionally, it's a very fair question to say, if Google's tweaking its algorithm, if you have partisan suppression of information from these very powerful platforms, how many votes is that swaying? I don't think there's any way that we really know. I don't think that 15 million estimate actually sounds correct, but I don't have any problem with him saying that.
And to me, this is so revealing of kind of what's going wrong on the right, is that directionally, there's something there. We know for a fact that Facebook and Twitter, monkeyed around with the Hunter Biden story at the very end. They were public about that.
Right.
That happened.
They were proud of it.
They said publicly, and then they said, well, this is so we don't spread misinformation, even though they weren't identifying anything that was wrong. in those articles. So directionally, is this possible? Yes. And so that, but then this is where the right goes wrong. A very smart congressman like Ken Buck then moves into, and it switched 15 million votes. It's like, whoa. Okay, we don't know exactly what the influence on the electorate of a tweak in Google's algorithm was, but I can promise you it's not 15 million votes. Trump only got, 73 million votes total.
Right.
15 million votes. That's like a quarter of the voting electorate.
Yeah.
Or the 20 to 25% of the entire. So he's guessing that something like 20 to 25% of the entire like Republican voting electorate moved because of their Google searches around Hunter Biden. Like I can promise anybody that's just crazy. And in fact, let's roll more of his clip. He says it correctly, in my opinion, or at least more accurately, later when Lauren presses him on this. And so let's hear how it could have been said if you're taking it a little bit more seriously.
Well, what I've heard from sort of the academics on this issue is that by changing the algorithm, you can flip 15 million votes. You can influence 15 million people to move one direction or another in that situation.
But that happened.
But it absolutely happened. Absolutely, the algorithm uh-huh. happened. So you talk to people, at conservative publications, mm-hmm. and what they'll tell you is the day after that algorithm went into effect, their readership went down. So if you were looking for something on the Washington Examiner or the Washington Times or the conservative newspapers in this area, mm-hmm. you would have to go further down. You have to go to page 2 or 3 to find the story you were looking for. And that's what Google did was by changing their algorithm. And it absolutely happened. We won't have a congressional investigation on it because the Dems control the House and the Senate. So we can't.
There's nothing you can do about it?
Nothing we can do about it. Well, we can do something when you give us
control. How do we win if they can do that every election?
Well, because we will win. The people are so upset with boys playing girls sports and critical race theory and all the other things that are going on that we will win the majority and we will hold hearings on this very issue in 2023. And that happens before the 2024 election.
And so I actually spoke a little too soon. That's still crazy. But what I meant was that if he says that the tweaking the algorithm can influence 15 million votes, by that he means that you can reach 15 million people by tweaking the algorithm, then I'm completely willing to accept that. The idea that that's going to then get them to change their votes from Trump to Biden, that's the part that I think is just completely indefensible on any level.
Yeah, I don't think it's good to have one of the leading antitrust lawmakers on the right, and that's an important thing to have on the right right now, and it is gaining momentum. I don't think it's particularly great that Ken Buck is using that number, because even if it is, as you say, Ryan, where he sort of does add the nuance where he's saying the academics have estimated that you can move 15 million votes.
Or you can influence. You can influence them. You can show them this information.
Right. And
what they do with that is,
again, you can look at how these studies were done and you can say, okay, yeah, that makes sense. But can we really quantify even people who aren't voting? Can we really do this meaningfully?
Everything we know about voting habits suggests that, that the Access Hollywood video that came out in 2016 didn't move a million votes probably. And not being able to find the Washington Times or the Washington Examiner is going to move 15 million. They don't have that many readers.
It really reminds me of Hillary Clinton talking about the second Comey investigation thing, and then how she's like, well, it moved X number of votes and I would have won, blah, 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 if that hadn't happened. And no, I just think I don't think it's productive. I do think, again, even when we play the second clip, pretty much what he's saying is correct. I think he's right about the boys playing girls sports and critical race theory point. Even if you disagree with the policies, or even if you agree with those policies, on the sort of political note, I think Republicans are right to say these culture war issues are working. Now, how they talk about them and campaign on them is a different story. It is sort of funny to hear it like that, to hear it so bluntly and almost so breezily. But the point about the algorithm is what he's talking about with Lauren Windsor. And he's saying, it's when she asks that happened, he's not saying, yes, 15 million votes changed. He's saying, yes, the algorithm shifted and it hurt, conservative publications. It had this huge effect. That trying to quantify it and put a number on it, I don't think that's particularly smart. But he does
If you want to put a number like a few thousand, I think you could do that. But to say 15 million, it's like, no. It's almost a willful misreading of the studies from him, where it's like, if 15 million people did the search, then he moved from every single one of those people was going to vote for Trump, looked for the Hunter Biden video, couldn't find the Washington Examiner link at the very top of their search results, and was, you know what, sticking with Uncle Joe.
Yeah, see, the hypothetical is absurd, and to imagine our ability to actually examine and study that to any conclusive evidence on a mass scale is absurd as well. So,
people think this stuff through, people. Next, we'll tell you what America's thinking.